By the age of 13, she was the opening act for the Jacksons. While at the top of the music chart, she decided to leave it all behind. After a 15-year hiatus, she's back. Please welcome Miss Stacy Ladislaw Jackson! Now, Miss Stacy, we have missed you. We love you. We have played your music time and time again because it's timeless. What have you been up to, Queen?
I've been raising my kids and enjoying it.
Yes, indeed.
I've been married for 19 years to the same man.
Talk about it.
And this, yeah.
Oh,
yeah. 19 years, we just had our 19th wedding anniversary, and I am so happy and content in my life. And there's no faith like that.
How'd you get there?
I had to go through some pain first. But I know I realized now it wasn't pain. The pain brought me into my purpose.
The pain brought her to the purpose.
Yeah.
Let's rewind for a minute. 12 years old. You in D.C. You at a park. You open your mouth and out comes magic. And then everything rushes in. Fame, the fortune, depressed, everything. How were you able to deal with that at 12 years old?
Actually, I was 9 years old when I sang in front of Fort Duval Park, and there was an estimated crowd of 30,000 people there. And that was our first live performance. Of course, I was very nervous, you know, but my mom gave me $10 and I did it.
For that money.
Oh, yeah. For $10, I did it. But I recorded my first album at 12. And people don't realize being a child star was very, very hard for me. And sometimes I have moments when I think about it. But where I am now, I'm just in a much better place now. But I suffered with panic attacks at 12 and 13 years old. Suffered with, you know, bouts of depression. And people only see the glamour and glitz of the entertainment business. They don't know what it's like to have all that stress and that type of, you know, I would say pressure on you. Mm-hmm. It was not for me, you know.
What was that thing, or what was that day you said, I'm done?
You know, I think it took a lot to get to that place because I was over at Atlantic Records, and then I went over to Motown Records, and I think at that point I was about maybe 22 years old, and I said I had enough of it, because actually what really put the icing on the cake for me was when the duet Don and I did Where Do We Go From Here. We were told that was the number one song on the Billboard chart for 4 weeks. We were told that song only sold 30,000 copies. I found it hard to believe. Johnny was like, we're going to get an attorney. He said he was like, you know, he was really, really heated about it, and I was upset myself. But at that point, I said, you know what? I'm going to walk away from it all. And many people didn't understand, how could you walk away from a number one song? That was like the highlight of my career. But like I said before, I didn't have any peace. And you can have all the money in the world, live in the finest house on the hill, but still be not happy, have, you know, this void on the inside and depressed and sad. And I always call people like that materially rich but spiritually poor. Come on now. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now let's talk about your book, I'm Not the Same Girl.
I'm not.
Let's talk about the book. What was it therapeutic for you to say, let me put it down here.
Yes,
let me
was.
Write it down. Let me share what I've been through if it's going to save another life.
You're right. That's what I had to do. And it's funny because when I was writing the book, it felt as if I was reliving my past. There were times when I cried. My husband can tell you there were times when I laughed because, you know, back then, there were nights when I would just cry because I wasn't so happy for so long. I was so unhappy. And I didn't have a normal childhood. I was picked on in school. I was called white girl, yellow girl, red girl, because I was light-skinned and had green eyes. You know, but people, kids can be cruel. You know, even the teachers in school, all this in my book, the teachers in school, I had problems with some of the teachers because I was 13 years old and had a top 10 hit on, radio and all that stuff. So, I went through a lot. But it's all good now.
I want to say this. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's all good now.